come to my studio. Today we're going to be working on Mr. Jack and Friends, and we're going to make this fun thing out of a candy pail, a jack-o'-lantern candy pail that you pick up from Walmart for under a buck. So let's get started. With our pail, you get to decide if you want to leave the color on the inside the way it is, or if you want to spray paint it all black as a base. If you want to leave the color the way it is, take your paper, two pieces of 8.5 by 11 paper, and put them inside the pail and spray paint the outside, and then the color doesn't get on the inside, and then cut it. Now, if you're going to do all of it and not worried about it, we're going to go ahead and cut out his face first. And I picked the candy pails with the simplest faces. I didn't want them to be real complicated or anything, so I just picked out the basic jack-o'-lantern faces. And I'm going to be doing a lot of these. We've got a lot of different things, different projects. So I am using a hot knife, and these are just a regular hot burner or wood burner that you find at your craft store or Walmart or anything like that, with the knife tip, and it is very, very hot, and you could cut it other ways if you wanted to. And I'm just going to follow, and it kind of, the term melts like butter. You don't want to push it, you just want the hot tip to kind of melt through it. And I found out if you kind of follow the back part first, that's how you kind of learn how to guide it. And I'm just simply cutting out all of the facial features. And I'm not worried about the edges, because we want them to kind of have a rustic feel anyway for the different things that we're using them for. So if you wanted to kind of make them smoother, you could go back with your knife a little bit, or you could even go back with your sandpaper and sand them down. You don't want any really rough edges, but you don't want them perfect. Now, I suggest doing this in a well-ventilated area. You might even wear your mask, just for any fume purposes. And we're gonna go ahead and finish cutting these guys. Like I said, I'm doing a lot of projects with these guys this year, even some Thanksgiving pumpkins, so make sure you check out all of the different videos. And just around his mouth, around the teeth. If you accidentally cut into a part, just stop, pull it out, and just leave that cut there. Don't worry about it, and just continue on. If you really like the cutout look, there you can look for the blades at Walnut Hollow. That's where I believe you can find them on the website. And I'm just going to go ahead and finish cutting this all the way around. It's not going to take me much time. If you don't want to cut it out, you can just paint this part. When we get to that part of the solid colors, we'll talk about that as well. Okay, I went ahead and finished cutting him, and then I spray painted him inside and out with a black spray paint. You want one that is for plastic that works really well. If you wanted to just do the paint, you could. It's just going to take a little bit longer. That's kind of a shortcut, but there's nothing wrong with that. I am using the multi-surface paint. I'm going to be using medium gray, and this is by Folk Art, so that really is important. It's something that will go to plastic and stay on plastic. And like I said, if you want to bi-step that, you could. It just makes it a little bit faster. So I'm going to use my craft sponge, and we're going to sponge on our gray. And I've wet it, but I've wrung it out. You don't want it so wet that it starts to run, and we're going to put this gray in the creases. And what I'm doing is I'm taking it, I'm putting it all the way down that line to get it in there, and then I'm sponging back over that top of it to give it that roughed up look. So we're going to do all the way around our pumpkin or jack-o'-lantern. And when we do his face, let's get close to his face here. What I do is you're going to do all of these little guys right through his face, right down the middle of his nose. And this is not perfect because we're going to come back up and we're going to cover a lot of this up, so that's not a big deal at all. And down that side there. And then I'm going to come back in and I'm going to go around his mouth, over his teeth. Make sure you cover up his teeth, and all the way around outside all of those. His eyes, his nose. Now, we were talking about if you didn't want to cut these out, then you could go ahead and fill them in. And on this one, I would fill them all the way in with gray, because we've got the black everywhere else. So I've got just a few more of these I'm going to do, and then we'll talk about the next step. You can leave the handle on if it helps you hold it, or if you want, if it's in your way, just go ahead and remove it, because we don't want it there anyway. So I've got all of that done, but we're also going to do around this top edge as well. So we want to make sure that we get all of that all the way around and get that sponged out. So anywhere there's a crease is basically kind of what we are after. We've got all of that. Okay, we're going to put our sponge in the water and rinse him off, and we're going to let that guy start drying, and we're going to go ahead and start on our Mr. Skeleton or Mr. Bones here. I found these at the 99-cent store the last couple of years, and I thought they were really cute. You could do a lot of fun things with them. I have seen them in other craft stores upwards of $29 for the half skeleton, maybe a little bit more jointed, but for 99 cents, this was really good deal. So the first thing I'm going to do is make him so he's not quite so stiff. I don't like the stiff arms. So we're going to melt those just a little bit, and I'm going to use ice water to set it, and I'm going to be using my heat gun to melt him. And we're going to do his joints a little bit. And you just want to get them to where they're bendable. You don't want to make the plastic mush. So just keep checking them there. And so I like him right about there. So what I'm going to do once I get him there is we're going to set him into our ice water. And then we have a different thing on him. Now I'm going to try and do his hands a little bit. Now because the hand I want to go down, I'm going to heat it a little bit more on the side I'm going down on, but the other side's still got to stretch. And I do these even with the little tiny plastic skeletons. Do a lot of things with those. This guy is not going to go as far, so we're just going to kind of get some just different movement in him than just being stiff. See the difference? See how much better that already is? So let's go ahead and get this side done. Thank you. going to turn the hand down just a little bit. I just love to do the Halloween stuff. There's so many things that you can do. Just take basic items and create new things. Of course, I have my Halloween attire on today. And I actually found that at the 99-cent store, too. Can you believe that? And see if we want him to go up or down or what we want to do with this guy. So, just enough so he's just not so stiff. You could have him up waving at everybody. You could have him giving the other one a high five. There's all kinds of fun things that you could do with him. All right, now that we've got him done, we're going to make him older a little bit, just kind of age him a little bit more than what he is. I have already put tape over his eyes. Again, we're going to be using the multi-surface paint, and I'm going to be using black. You could use gray, but it wouldn't quite show up as much. And we're just going to rub it here and there and wipe it off. Now, the parts that we want in the creases, we're going to wet our paintbrush just a tad, and we're going to get it into those creases. Now, don't worry, I'm not going to leave them like that. And we're going to come in and just really start wiping all of that off. So we start to get this really kind of spooked up look to him. Now I could have watered that down a little bit more. See that difference already there? The black is going to stay in those areas. I'm going to do a little bit more water. Do it through the veins in his head, or the bones in his head, excuse me. And the more you don't want it on there, wet your thing down and take it just a little bit. See how much better that already is than what he was. The eyes I'm going to leave darker. And for the bone parts, if you just want to kind of dry brush them without any water in there, or if you want to get them in there and do it just like we did on top, you can. Whatever you prefer. Now I'm going to do the hands same kind of way we did before. So I want them to get down in there. Use your old rags or paper towels. And then that's going to leave all of that in there. I save my old dish rags after we're done with them and use them. So now that we're starting to get him more kind of old looking, you can rub it as much as you want, as little as you want. There's no right or wrong. You can use the two methods, one for the method down below, and then wipe it off, or the method I'm using now, just kind of dry brushing it on what kind of sticks out. Either way is great. You want it darker, do more. You want it lighter, do less. But see how much better he already looks than he did when we first started him. We just kind of really aged him. And then what I do is let him dry just a little bit. And then I take him outside and I spray him really, really well with my glow-in-the-dark paint so that we have that extra spooky feel even more so. So I'm going to, I was going to stop and take a layer of paint off, but let's just keep on going because we're just going to get messier as we go here. So I'm going to use my texture multi-surface paint again, and we're going to start doing the pumpkin. This is a great place for a dry board while this is drying, but we're going to start with this now and my craft sponge, and I'm going to just dip into my paint. And what we're going to do is we're going to pounce down the middle of our sections and show you in a second here. So once we have those sections kind of covered between the gray, we're going to come back in and we're going to just kind of lightly go between the two, and the area that is lower is not going to get covered up. You're actually going to see that gray kind of line there. If you want it to show up more, then just kind of do it on the side like that and just leave it a little bit more. So we're going to do around his face, same kind of way that we just did the sides. And on the part where there's a lot of gray, kind of just once in a while hit it in with the black. And I should have done this guy too down here. A little bit of black on those teeth. Just make sure you're leaving that gray showing through. Remember when I said when you have a whole bunch of gray on the eyes, just hit a little black right there. So you want it to kind of be a shadow or kind of a stone look to it or a bone look to it. I'm going to go ahead and finish this all the way around now, and then we'll continue on. Now that I've gone all the way around and he's still wet, that's okay. I'm going to take my gray and we're going to come back in and just lightly hit it there in here and there. And you can always come back over it with your black, and that's probably what we'll do in just a second. But it gives it kind of that stone feel, and that's why we sponge it on instead of paint it on. It gives it more of a natural feel, kind of sandy, coarse feel, rock, I guess, kind of feel to it. So we're just lightly, I'm going to get a little bit on those teeth again. But it also kind of breaks up the black. And then just so you don't just see where the sponge is, you just kind of want that molten look. And don't worry about it being perfect. You could sit there and play with it all day. Just kind of. I also did bring in my black tray, and these trays I do find usually in the spring at the dollar stores. They're a boot tray and they're really great for crafts and messes. I use them all the time. So we're gonna go ahead and let him dry really, really well, and I'm gonna take him out and spray him with my glow in the dark, and then I'll spray him with matte varnish and we'll put him together. The other things we're going to do is we're going to cut a hole into the back of our candy pail, and you could do this before you paint it, but after you've done it too is fine. We just got the blue showing, but we'll cover that up. And now I've got everything dry. I've got my varnish on top, my flat varnish, so it's not shiny, it's kind of spooky looking. And then I also have my glow in the dark on my skeleton. So now I'm going to take his eye coverings off So we should have these little red stones. Hopefully they're still red. And if you wanted to clean up and put black around there so he doesn't have squares in his eyes, you can go ahead and do that at this time too. So he's ready to go in. And I picked up lights, mini lights from the Dollar Tree. And that one I have orange, and this one I'm going to do purple. And we're going to thread them up through that bottom hole that I just put into our pail. Just thread them in there just like that. There. And I kind of want those sticking up towards the front of his face so they shine through. And I'm going to use Spanish moss behind it. And you can tape it with electrical tape to kind of hold it in place, or you can just kind of place it with your fingers. I kind of hold it up there, get my Spanish moss kind of up there, and then kind of move it around from the front. That's totally up to you. Another thing I do with these is I put in a rock. The flatter, the better. It's going to help hold everything in place, keep it from blowing away, not be top heavy, and those kind of things. So that's kind of important. We're going to insert our Mr. Skeleton, he's backwards here. And he just fits in there. And then we're going to put some more moss behind him. And if you need to, what I did last time is I actually took my light box and squished it a little bit. I use everything. And put it behind him to help hold him in position back here so he doesn't fall forward. And then we're going to go ahead and finish him up with the Spanish moss. And I glued a little creature on him. You could glue whatever type of creature. You could put spiders all over. You could put the crow on. You can do all kinds of fun things. So just, you know, don't get stuck in what I'm showing you. So there is our Jack and Friends. And like I said, I think it'd be fun to add some more little creepy creatures to it. You could add some snakes and stuff coming out. And maybe we'll have to try that. But we've also got Mr. Bones, which is going to be another skeleton with hands. So come on over and check that out. And make sure you give us a thumbs up, like us, and share our video. Subscribe to us on YouTube so that you can get all of the latest videos coming out. Thank you. God bless.